and cold this morning, warming up a bit this afternoon. He's killing at least 49 soldiers and 13 civilians.
That hasn't stopped a small group of death penalty protesters from Central Missouri University down there at the prison this morning. See, tonight marks the execution of serial killer Otis Boyle, and they're protesting that and, well, pretty much everything else about that place. They say the conditions inside are disgusting, terrifying, quote, inhumane. Let me ask you this, do these monsters deserve any better? And does somebody who killed 26 people that we know of deserve better than his own murderous medicine? If you ask me, they should find a way to kill the bastard twice.
Welcome back, York. How was your little mandatory vacation?
Good, Warden, good. I got a lot of work done on myself.
You still seem a little angry to me, York. You sure you're managing? I'm kidding.
You know, if it was up to me, you wouldn't be taking any frou-frou classes. But we gotta follow policy. Without it, we're lost.
Well, I'm just glad to do whatever it takes to keep this job. It's my life, sir.
Oh, hell, we've all wanted to knock Boyle's teeth in. Today we get to do something even worse to him. Legally.
Captain York, good to see you again.
Otis Boyle, the I-55 slasher, the Midwest Manson, the Great Plains gravedigger. Today's your day. Now, the honorable tradition of a civil execution in the great state of Missouri, you are entitled to a last meal, a humane grace we extend to separate ourselves from the beasts. You decide on a last meal, Boyle?
Yes, sir. I have.
And what'll it be, Boyle?
Human flesh, sir. You're gonna laugh at a man's last request? Not very civil.
Come off it, Boyle, be serious.
I am. I've made my choice.
Then make a different choice, goddammit. Sorry.
Are you really going to be the warden that breaks with centuries of tradition in this great prison?
You aren't actually considering this, are you, sir?
We are officially behind schedule.
You don't think I can tell the difference between the flesh of a human and a fucking dirty animal?
Warden, let's not entertain this for another second. Boyle clearly has chosen to forego his final meal.
We give inmates their meal of choice. It's policy, tradition, it's civil.
Listen, your job's already on thin ice. I need a solution from you. Do you remember what I told you when I promoted you? That with enough will, we are capable of anything.
Yeah, that sounds familiar, sir.
The question is, do you still have that will?
Yes, sir.
Come on, son.
All right, just give me a minute. I'm gonna do it.
Man up and make a cut.
Okay. Okay. Here we go. Here we go.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
No, I can do it.
Suck it up, York. You're gonna lose your shit, or are you gonna manage? Shit. This ain't enough for a meal.
What?
It's not called a last snack, York. It's a meal. Do you want to do the parts of the job that you want to do, or do you want to do this job right?
I do the whole job, sir.
All right. Got this bastard Wayne. Got just enough time to get him drumstick. Here's your last meal, Boyle.
See you in hell, Boyle.
It's a long trip. Better eat first.
What is that?
And he thought we couldn't uphold the tradition.
Right.
Don't stray too far, Father. We're gonna need those last rites post-haste.
Y'all know why I started eating? Human? See, I heard an old legend. And when you eat someone's meat, you absorb all their strength and all their power. And that might have been true when men had to kill what they ate. Nowadays, when men hide behind uniforms and guns and desks and lies and bad comb-overs, bullshit ideas of what they call strength that they fill their whole sad fucking lives with. You know what I taste here? Weakness and fear. That's fine by me. Cause nobody likes tough meat. And weakness tastes like fucking candy.
Fuck you! I'll show you what real strength is! Well, we're now officially ahead of schedule.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
You gave a lot of yourself today to uphold your civic duty. You have a long future in this institution.
Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.